Nice. Traditional local breakfast buffet.
Otherwise known as welcome to Latvia.
You better get used to the smell.
Yes, Boris!
What the beer was that?
Well, I went to Latvia, because nobody actually ever goes there. I mean, who the hell does? Seriously, the one person that you know who went to Latvia, I will wait. So to get my Latvia experience going from day one, I stepped inside the first shop.
Bulchina, staring share.
Тут он чай мило туда. What the блин, have they done to this chicken? After going past the deep dried section, I found boxes with interesting writing. Wait, hold on, what is this? I would rather not try. Picked up something that looked like sour cream, some very Slav looking пряники, some mayonnaise of the Latvian kind, and of course, some kvass. So I stepped out to have a snack, and upon closer inspection, I realized how little money I spent on this full gobnik meal. Now I have to say this mayonnaise was quite shit, but I did get a chance to try the local pряник with a bit of high class sour cream. For those who do not know what a pряник is, it is like a gingerbread you eat all year round. So here is my one advice, if you ever go to Latvia, and I know you won't, for the love of blin, try out this combination. It was so good. The kvass, pretty average. But then again, this was kvass number one. And that is when I thought, I will try every kvass I can find. So I went to Riga. Until I got to this traffic light that was red for like 10 minutes. Why are you trying to keep me from kvass? And another one just because they can. Maybe just was the world telling me, no Boris, kvass is bad for you. What kind of debil put this up? After a few hours of driving, I end up in capital city and see a hotel in the style of Eastern Bloc high-rise apartment building. Needless to say, it felt like home. I went inside and said, please give me a room worthy of the Shashlik King. And they said, yes, of course, hello Boris, how are you doing? Take elevator to third floor and walk to end of hall. Your Slavic suite will be ready. Опа! It will be a Slavic day. So what do we have? Some free coffee and a machine. It's not bad. I mean, some class samples would have been nice, but... someone has been making waffles. Again, now this is impressive. It's an ironing table in hotel room, блин. Okay, time to go. Okay, cannot forget to iron the shank. New city, new people, need to look respectable. Like yes, edieni, но this I understand. Some boiled potatoes, spreads, herring, and that is cottage cheese. And add some onion on top, and boom, you're one of them. Outside of the hotel there was a very large pool. Something I did not expect from this gobnik luxury. The water was nice and warm, but sadly I was too busy for a swim. So if you have seen one of my previous videos on Lithuania, you will know that I completely disregarded all town. So I thought, okay. Latvia? Riga? Блин, might as well. So I squat down and make a plan to check out all town. So I cross the bridge from the hotel and suddenly I'm assaulted with some kind of strange alien sounds. So I quickly left and found all town with some slow moving gobniks and some more gobniks with just one strap. Higher class, no doubt. I quickly learned some Latvian. Matu, Grežuns, Krauso, Sana, Vešu, Nona, Sana. and already felt educated. Because to learn Latvian it is to forget about every language you have ever known. Because for me it sounds more like chanting of the swamp people. Here we see typical old town parking. Because a handicap can be many things. Even the disability to read signs. Oh, this is Estonian, what the shit. Right next to the handicapped businessman, there was a souvenir shop. I wonder how much for the red button. It was not for sale. And then I realized Riga is a very provocative place. People screaming in streets, no selling of red buttons to people, and then this thing here. If you haven't tasted it, you have not been in Riga. Tasted what? What are you selling here? Provocative statements like that, they make me not want to taste Riga at all. But despite a repelling slogan, I was feeling a thirst for Kvass. This one, a lot more fresh. Did not taste at all like someone has been fermenting it in their sock drawer. A solid 6.5 out of 10. Squatting gotniks. Not bad, but the adventure continues. The adventures of KVASSMAN. But the one I had the day before was a weak sloppy 3. Good enough for washing down a stale chaburek, but nothing you would bring back home to mom.
Typical Latvian dish, marinated pork hock. Smoked in best Latin traditions, assorted fish platter.
19 euros! How rich do I think I am? Блин. Greek olives, nah, you see, 350, just I can afford. But instead I went for goulash soup. Goulash. Yes. What kind of scam is this? This is potatoes, not meat. After receiving a refund, I saw justice taking place. Oh look, this guy got fined for not parking in the handicap zone. And went on to find food somewhere else. Literally anything will do. I wonder if this guy knows his rear axle is going to fall off. So I find this place called Late Night Munches. But since pizza schelle and burgeri is not what I want, I went to a bar next door. A bar that was suggested by a fan. It is called Alla Folks Bar or something. And as it seems that some people do sleep in the city, this place was still closed.
Well shit, did I not get a memo that I was coming?
So naturally, I went to investigate and to see if maybe they left the back door open.
Machine breeki, container room, nano veti dot, 50 euro.
Maybe it's a good thing I do not understand the language. Sadly, none of the doors was open. So I left in bitter disappointment. But that was nothing compared to what happened next.
Put a sign up, debil!
And so, after being covered in industrial waste, and being denied access to the pub, I went to search for a shop instead. Thankfully there was one nearby. And again, I was feeling the thirst for Kvass. And that is exactly what I got. And I'm not sure if it was my extreme thirst or maybe the glass bottle that made it taste so good. But that was a solid 7. 7 out of 10. I do suggest KVASSMAN away. Like they're not even trying to come up with names anymore. Caffeine, what's next? Well, welcome to my new Shashlik place. It is called Pig Beats on a Stick. So that's how they make money from selling cheap kvass. I should have known. So as I still had more time, I remember that there was one more place that someone suggested I visit. And this is not that place. But instead it was called Uncle Vanya. And with a name like that, I was expecting caviar, vodka, more kvass, and some semechki on the side. But no, I did not get any of those things. Because apparently Uncle Vanya's place is no place for gopnik like me. So if you plan to go to Riga, and I know you won't, make sure you do not wear a hoodie to the Russian restaurant. Because instead of the menu, they will show you the door. As a last attempt of redemption, I did try to get some shashlik nearby. But I guess my search was not accurate enough.
Three wise men of the world.
Who is the best Kvass maker of them all? You are, Boris. Now leave this place.
Well, yes, but I mean locally.
Опа!
So I sat down, ordered my class number 4, and tried that, the beer platter. It cost 4 of the local currency, so I did not expect much. With the atmosphere of a dungeon, and my stomach being very empty, this cold and crisp kvass gave a strong sensation of childhood memories. And that is why it gets a very high 8.5 out of 10. Kvassman is pleased. And that was not the only pleasing aspect. This beer platter, my friends, is only comparable to one I had in Slovakia. If I was the garlic bread man, I would give this the perfect 10. As the clock was nearing the time of 3, I went back to the hotel to find out some more places for kvass, because I knew there was one more place that I have been many years ago. In the hotel, you could buy a samovar, or a clock, and many more things from the Soviet era. Back in the hotel room, I had a strong coffee to get a taste of garlic bread out of mouth. And then I heard this screaming from the streets. But it was okay. It's just a local copniks having a nice argument. I finished my coffee and go back to exploring Riga. After a bit, I arrive in a place with a windmill. And then memories start coming back to me. This is the place that I had a kvass all those years ago. The place is called Lido. And if you have been to Riga, you probably have been here as well. So two large jars of kvass and more stuff I just happened to pick up was the dinner that I had. And yes, the drink was exactly as good as I remember. For this trip, all around 10. Very well done. I went outside, took a couple of pictures of one of my dream cars, and went to check out Moskva Zela. Now this place apparently has a reputation for not being the friendliest place after dark. But since I do not have a very good camera and I was driving a car that's not mine, then I decided to go before dark, at around 8 o'clock in the evening. And not just did it look friendly, but it also looked like a very good place to be. Cheap housing, cobblestone streets so people do not exceed the limit, every other house looks like babushka lives in it, and someone's probably does, and every day there is a Gopnik auto show on every street. Some nice cheap public transport driving in front of your own house. But would I live here? Probably not. Cobblestone's not good for gas suspension, you know? And I found no place for kvass. So I went to store and got some. When I finally got back to the hotel, there was a large man singing on the screen, but I was much more interested in the kvass I bought. It was warm, it was a bit too sweet, I would say an average 5 out of 10. But I guess the taste of kvass depends on many more things than just the quality of drink. It is more bad when you drink it. I did buy a lot more other stuff from the shop, but the review of those things is long enough to make a separate video, so write in comments if you would like to see it. But for now, this concludes the adventures of KvassMan. Let me know what you think about this new, more vlog-style travel video. Yes, no, could be zets. And for those who are wondering why it took so long to make this video, then rewind and watch it again. But for now, I say thank you for watching, my friends. I will see you next time, and stay cheeki breeki.